What's going on, guys? This is me and welcome back into my channel. And today I'm going to make this video a special request from our viewers from Bangladesh. Shout out to Saiful, who makes this video a very successful, especially to making this content. And here I'm going to help you guys to understand about the smartwatch SPO2 or the oxygen level. And we're going to do a series of testing. And before I start this video, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now. And we're going to see about this testing. All right, and here is the smartwatch. So I just bought it, and this is the GST having the SPO2 oxygen level. I'm going to test the five objects here. So let's start with the bread here, and let's try to put it in the bread there and just wait for a few more minutes. And the oxygen level is 100%. And second is the box here of an earbuds. Let's see if it is working or not. I'm going to place it in the printed of the earbuds of the box. And it's also working. And let me try also to our Squirtle toy there. Squirtle is made up of plastic, so it has a greater resistance of the infrared sensor. Right, so it's not working. And another is the QCY T6, which is a sports earbud from QCY. Right, so it's also not working. And last is the silicone case of the mobile device. Right, so let's try to put the smartwatch and try to calibrate our SPO2. And it seems to be 100% working in the silicone case. Alright, so that was the testing of our smartwatch into our some of the materials there. So it's kind of confusing, why does it work with some of the materials, why it's not. And here also, we're going to have a test it with our toys here from Pikachu. So here is our Pikachu, so it's a very big Pikachu, and today he's going to test it also if the blood oxygen is working or not. So let me try to assist Pikachu because he has a small hand. So let me try to wear it into his wrist, a little bit of tightness there into his hand. And he's now ready to test smartwatch with an blood oxygen level. So there you go, guys. So let me try to calibrate it, and let's get Pikachu come close to our camera. All right, so it seems to me that the smartwatch is working with Pikachu with a 97% of blood oxygen and some pulse rate out there. Now Pikachu is very happy. And the explanation here, Pikachu is made out of cotton. Now the cotton is actually absorbing the red LED light here. So when we try to calibrate our smartwatch, it's made up of reflective sensors and releasing the infrared red LED light. And it seems to be that this cotton does absorb the red LED light, and it gives us a result compared to the pulse oximeter. It's having the same function. I'm going to put also a cotton inside the pulse oximeter and we'll see if there's a result on it. But it seems to be it keeps on reading and reading, and it doesn't give the oxygen level result. The difference also is because the smartwatch is having the reflective sensors compared to the pulse oximeter is having the sensors on the other side. Why did it absorb the cotton material compared to the other materials? It's because when the red infrared LED light passes through the oximeters, and it will have a less absorption compared to the when the red LED light has less reflection into the other side of the pulse oximeter. So the magic word here is actually the infrared LED light passing from one location to the other, passing through its object. Now the question here, does it work also with the liquid or carbon dioxide or probably a soda? So here I'm going to bring out a soft drinks. I've just pulled out Fanta, which is one of my favorite, and there's low sugar on it. Here let's try to open the Fanta, and let's try to put it in the glass of water. And in the glass of water, you can see a lot of carbon dioxide there. So there you can see a carbonated drinks which has a lot of oxygen and sparkles on it. And let's try our smartwatch there. Right, so so it seems to be it's not going to work. Why? It's because most of the liquid has lesser absorption of the red LED light because it passes through, as you can see. And even when you try to beam up a red LED light into the glass of water, you can still see that the red LED light will pass into the liquid. How about people who has low hemoglobin? Now I have a friend here who has a 7.4 hemoglobin there. And in this part, I'm going to test it with a person who has anemia or has anemic. And I'm going to test him with a smartwatch. and it's going to take a few seconds, and it seems to be normal even though the person has a low hemoglobin. So the key word here is actually the absorption of the red LED light into the material. So that was the testing of our smartwatch with an SPO2 or blood oxygen level. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, and if you have any questions, just comment below and we'll try to talk about it. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now, and see you in my next testing video. Bye bye. Thank you.